During a dialogue organized by the Netherlands Institute for Multi-Party Democracy in Kampala on Thursday, female politicians joined from local governments, parliament and the diplomatic corps narrated harrowing stories of sexual harassment at the hands of their voters, colleagues and bosses. Former Kumi Woman Member of Parliament Monica Amoding said sexual harassment in parliament is rife, only that female MPs keep quiet about it.
Because as you go higher, there are certain things you just choose to keep quiet about. If Honorable Sylvia came out, they are one in a million women. So also, the manifestations of violence against women in politics are all around us.
The female leader said sexual harassment in political leadership is not only present in high places, but also from the grassroots, from voters through profane sexual language, bad touches and insults. Christine Mugira, the Assistant Secretary General of Democratic Party, urged female politicians to be aware of sexual harassment and innovate ways of protecting themselves against it when they join politics.
People, please, women, understand that we are on a journey for equal, for recognition that we are also human beings. This is a journey we've been walking. But you know that what you're doing, you're challenging a system they call patriarchy. Now, you know that every time you articulate something like, what about the boy child? Patriarchy is fighting back at what you really are doing.
Edith Sempala, Uganda's former ambassador to US, said sexual harassment is not only limited to political corridors of power, but also the diplomatic corps where she served for over two decades.
We have made it look like it is. It's it is okay. It is part of the casualty of politics. You know, it must not be acceptable. And ladies, we are 52%. We always call ourselves as if we are just 20% of the population, and therefore helpless at the mercy of these people who are less in numbers than us. They are less. Because also not all men are abusers.
The Lira District Woman Member of Parliament, Linda Agnes Auma, urged fellow politicians to be extra careful as many people are ready to take advantage of their gender.
As you are in politics, be careful with such people. From a male, that person would be either hired to destroy you, or
revenge,
or give you the last hit of your life that you remember forever. Or to bury you. They look at your passion and want to bury it so that they are at peace. So be careful the people you will interface. Politics is where you meet all categories of people. Mm-hmm. And identifying them is very difficult.
Story compiled by John Musenze for the news.